Praise the Lord. Greetings to you all in the precious name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today I want to speak to you about fixing your eyes on Jesus. If you go to the book of Matthew chapter 14, verse 22 to 33, we read in this passage about Jesus walking on water. After preaching to the crowd of people, Jesus went to the mountainside to pray, while the disciples went out to the sea to do their usual trade, that is fishing. It was early in the morning and it was still dark when Jesus went out to his disciples walking on the water. When the disciples saw him, they were afraid. They thought it was a ghost. But Jesus said to them, "Take courage, don't be afraid, it's me." Then Peter said to Jesus, Master, if it is you, let me come to you. Let me come to you walking on the water. And Jesus said to Peter, "Come." And Peter began to walk on the water towards Jesus. But when Peter saw how big the waves were, how fierce the winds were, he became afraid and he began to sink. He cried out, "Lord, save me." And Jesus reached out his hands and picked him up and said to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" Now from this Bible passage, there are a number of life lessons we can draw from this passage. But I want to speak to you about fixing our eyes on Jesus. We see, as long as Peter's eyes was on Jesus, he was able to walk on the water. But as soon as he moved his eyes away from Jesus, he began to sink. He began to drown. It is when Peter saw how big and how fierce the waves were, how big and fierce the winds were, how strong the winds were, he was afraid. He became afraid and he began to sink. When did this happen? When did he begin to sink? When his eyes was no longer on Jesus. Just like Peter, we will also encounter storms in our life. We will experience strong winds and storms in our life. But if our eyes is on Jesus, we will not drown, we will not sink. If our eyes are on Jesus, no matter how big the waves are, no matter how strong the winds are, we will not be afraid. We should always keep our eyes on Jesus. We don't need to be afraid. We don't need to panic, for Jesus is right beside us. Life will throw us all kinds of problems to us. Sickness, death of a loved one, storms of financial problems. Maybe your children aren't living right for God. Maybe you have a difficult spouse. Maybe you have a spouse that is not serving God no more. You have a difficult partner. Maybe you're struggling with depression. Maybe you're struggling with addiction. No matter what problems you're going through, let us fix our eyes on Jesus. When we fix our eyes on Jesus, the problem of life will not drown us. When our eyes are on Jesus and when sickness comes into our life, we will say that by his stripes we are healed, Isaiah 53 verse 5. No matter what problems comes our way, when our eyes are on Jesus, we will see victory in our life. We will be able to walk on the water. The problems of life will not drown us. When our families or children, when our loved ones are not serving the Lord, when our spouse is not serving the Lord, we will say, "As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." Where was Jesus when Peter began to sing? Jesus was right there, right beside Peter. The Bible says, Jesus says to us, "I will never leave you nor forsake you." Remember, Jesus is always with us, no matter what we go through in life. Jesus is always with us. He will never leave us. He will never forsake us. When Peter began to drown, when Peter began to sink, he cried to Jesus and Jesus stretched forth his hands and saved Peter. It is natural for us human beings, when faced with storms, when faced with difficulties or situations in life, we get afraid, we panic, we begin to doubt. But in all and everything, Jesus is saying to us, "Don't doubt, don't be afraid, I'm here, I'm right here with you." Because of our lack of faith, because of our trust issues in the Lord, we go through those difficult moments. We find ourselves in a difficult situation. Even if we fall, even if we begin to sink and drown, remember, my friends, Jesus is right there with you. Where was Jesus when Peter began to drown? Jesus was right there beside Peter. In the same way, he is right there with us. He's stretching his hands to you. He stretched his hands towards Peter and lifted him up. When Peter began to drown, he cried to Jesus, and Jesus saved him. In our storms, in our struggles, in our difficulties, let us cry to God in prayer, in faith, call upon him. The Bible says, those who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Romans 10:13. Friends, when we have fallen in life, Jesus is stretching his hands to us. Will we give our hands to him? Will we stretch our hands towards him as well? He longs to save us. He longs to rescue us. He longs to make us whole. He longs to love us. No matter what you have done in your life, no matter what you have done to have fallen, Jesus still loves you. Jesus still cares for you. He is right beside you. His arms are stretched towards you in love. Will you reach out to him? Will you accept his love and forgiveness that he has to offer to you? In the end, I want to say, the Christian walk is not easy, and life is not easy in itself as well. We all go through stuffs in life, but I want to encourage you, no matter what we go through in life, we must fix our eyes on Jesus. I want to encourage you to fix your eyes on Jesus always, no matter what you go through in your life. Even if you have fallen, Jesus longs to pick you up. He will make you his beloved child. Thank you. God bless you. And let us end with a word of prayer. Dear God, precious loving Heavenly Father, we come to you once again, Lord. We thank you, Father God, for the word that has been shared today, Lord. I pray, Father God, help us to fix our eyes on you, Lord. No matter what difficulties, what storms, what struggles we may face in our life, Lord, whether it be it in our marriage, whether it be it in our finances, whether it be with our children, Lord, or it be with our health, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you'll help us to fix our eyes on you, Lord. Help us to stay strong, Lord. And when we have fallen, Lord, help us, Lord, to get back up, Lord. I pray that you'll stretch forth your hands and pick us up, Lord, and make us whole, Lord. We commit our lives, Lord, into your hands, Lord. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you all, and God bless you.